Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hi guys, hello. In this particular video, we will learn some different type of multistage amplifier, and that different type is with some different connection of BJT mode. So we let's understand the fact that right now we have understood that CSCS, CECE, CSCE amplifier, but not yet we have studied the CB or CG configurations and along with CE configuration or CS configuration, right? So we are in this particular video, we will learn the same type of BJT configuration with different modes, and these modes, when they do cascade with each other, that forms your different type of amplifier that is called as Cascode amplifier. This Cascode amplifier have ample of characteristics, and this characteristics along with the DC analysis that we'll have to learn in this particular video. Now let's look at this particular slide in front of you, that is Cascode amplifier. Here we have to specify that the transistor which we are using for this Cascode amplifier is BJT, that is bipolar junction transistor. So if you look at this particular circuit that comprises of two transistors, so obviously with the two transistors I will be having two stages. So it's an example of multistage amplifier. So what is the khasiyat of this particular Cascode amplifier, and why it is different than that of usual cascade amplifier, right? So see to it that input is given to the first stage Q1, base of first stage, that is input is given to the base of first stage, and the emitter is your common. I can say that this is nothing but comprises of your common emitter mode, right? And this particular output which is given to the connector side, which is given to the input of the transistor 2, that is Q2, through emitter terminal, and the base is connected to the ground, and I can say that this is your common base configuration. So here I can conclude that yes, this Cascode amplifier is called as common emitter, common base configuration. Common emitter is earlier than common base. This is because common emitter is at the input side, common base is at the output side. We are clubbing two parameters together, CE and CB, two modes together, CE and CB. One is CE. Khasiyat of CE is to get moderate gain, right? Khasiyat of CB is to get the higher bandwidth. And these two, when I combine together, I'll get a good sandwich that is called as a Cascode amplifier, which is having both the characteristics into one particular circuit only. Usually we have gain bandwidth product should be constant, right? So if gain increases, your bandwidth reduces. When bandwidth increases, your gain reduces. So we want to build a bridge in between them, right? So to have moderate gain, high gain, as well as we want to have the high bandwidth. So this is been achieved by this particular amplifier called as a Cascode amplifier. So the basically khasiyat of this Cascode amplifier is we'll be getting the high bandwidth and we'll be getting the moderate to high gain as well, right? So let's learn the DC perspective, DC analysis perspective of this Cascode amplifier. Before that I just want to note that I am purposely taking the CE mode at the base side, not CB mode at the base side. This is because I know that the input impedance of CB is very, very less. I want input impedance should be high enough. So as far as CE is concerned, the input impedance is high enough than that of your base part. Moreover, the output impedance of the base is very, very high as compared to CE. So this is how we want that particular Cascode amplifier. And this is nothing but the khasiyat of Cascode amplifier. Let's move towards the next slide where we'll do the DC analysis of this Cascode amplifier. Just opening all the coupling and bypass capacitors, whatever circuit we'll be getting, that will be your DC analysis circuit. Now in this particular circuit, we will have to deal with the approximations, right? So what kind of approximations we have to learn, that is beta is very, very high than 100. If beta is very, very high than 100, then I can say that IB1 and IB2 can be neglected. Right? If I do neglect this IB1 and IB2, I can easily get the value of VB2 and VB1. So here I can say that the value of the at this particular node is nothing but VB2. Value at this particular node is nothing but VB1. Okay, so let's move ahead to the calculation of VB1 and VB2, right? So VB1 is equal to, I can say that I'll just apply the VDR over here. So R3 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3 multiplied by the total voltage, that is nothing but VCC minus of minus VEE, that is plus VEE. So we can say that the value is nothing but R3 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3 multiplied by VCC plus VEE. Okay, so this is the value of VB1. Similarly, I can calculate the value of VB2 as well. So VB2 is equal to the summation of these two resistances R2 plus R3 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3 multiplied by the total voltage, that is VCC plus VEE. So these two values we have got here, right? Now we have to deal with the value of the current, right? So I'm assuming that if IB1 and IB2 is been neglected, can I say that all the collector and emitter currents are same? So if IB is 0, I can say that IC1 is equal to IE1, and that IC1 itself is IE2. So I can also say that IE2 is equal to IC2. So here I can conclude that IC1 is equal to IC2 is equal to IE1 is equal to IE2 is, let's say, IC. So it's having same value, right? When I'm considering beta is much greater than 100. Then say that if this is the case, then I can say that apply KVL, right? What we will do? We'll apply KVL here, right? If you apply KVL here, we'll be getting VB1, right? This VB1 is equal to VBE1. So this voltage is nothing but VBE1, and this is nothing but IE into RE. So apply KVL. To, let's say, loop A, and I'm doing namakaran for this loop as loop A. Okay, let's say what we'll be getting, that is nothing but say VB1 is equal to VBE minus IERE. From that we have all values of this particular parameters except IE. So we'll get the value of IE, that is the first parameter of current from the DC analysis we'll be getting. That is nothing but VB1 minus VBE divided by RE. That is nothing but the first equation. I will write it as the first equation for your current, right? Once we get the value of IE, I can assume that we will be having all the values of IC1, IC2, IE1, IE2, that is the same value as IC. So we have got the current value. Now we want to learn what will be the value of CE1, CE2, right? Only two values are left, then we're done with DC analysis. Now how will we be getting the value of this particular thing, that is VCE1 first we'll calculate. I know that this VB2, right? This VB2 is comprises of VBE2 plus VCE1 and this VE, right? So I can say that once we get the value of IE, we can move further for the from VB2 we'll be getting. I can say that this VB2 is equal to, this VB2 is equal to VBE2 plus VCE1 plus IE into RE. Okay, so far we have all the values of this particular parameter except this VCE1. So we have got already the value of VCE1 from this particular equation, that is VB2 minus VBE2 minus VIE into RE. Okay, so I can say that this is the second equation I have got, and from this particular equation we'll direct jump for the KVL at the output node. So what we will do, we will say apply KVL at the output node. Okay, KVL at the output loop, I can say. So let's see to it that, okay, so we have to incorporate this particular VEE that I forgot. So if we say that VE is equal to 0, that will be grounded, then that this will be the equation of IE. So if VEE is given, then what we'll have to do, we just have to add that value of VEE, minus of minus VEE, that will become plus VEE. Here we'll be getting minus of VEE, and minus of minus will become here, we'll be getting plus VEE. So in this equation, you just have to modify this equation as VB1 minus VBE plus VEE divided by RE. That will be your equation for IE. And further, we have to again modify this equation as well. That is nothing but IE RE minus of minus VEE. So here we will be getting the value of VCE is nothing but VB2 minus VBE2 minus IERE plus VEE. Okay, so far so well, in accordance with the value of VEE, that is negative value of DC voltage which is given at the emitter side. So let's see that we want to have another output voltage, that is for Q2, that is VCE2. So let's apply KVL at the output. Apply KVL at output, right? Output loop, I can say. Right? For output loop, we will be starting from VCC minus, can say that IC, or I can say that IC2 into RC2, right, minus VCE2 minus VCE1 minus IE into RE, right, minus of minus, that is plus VEE is equal to 0. We just want to find out the value of VCE2. We'll kick this value of VCE2 towards the right hand side. So VCE2, that is equal to VCC plus VEE minus VCE1 minus IC2 into RC2 minus IE into RE, and that will be your equation number 3. This is how we have done with the DC analysis of Cascode Amplifier. So far we have discussed about the Cascode Amplifier. The Cascode Amplifier is used to get the higher bandwidth, moderate gain with CE and CB configuration if you are using the BJT, and we have done with the DC analysis of Cascode BJT amplifier. So thank you so much for watching this video. In upcoming videos, we will learn the AC analysis and frequency analysis, higher and lower frequency analysis of Cascode amplifier. So stay tuned for that. Learn more and more ADC along with me, along with Ekeeda videos. Subscribe all the Ekeeda videos. Thank you so much.